Καλά,
θα πω κι εγώ για να ξεκινήσω το κομμάτι. Πρέπει να ολοκληρώσει το κομμάτι. Και τώρα πάρε το χαρτάκι.
Καλά, ίσως μπορούν να μεταγράψουν το χρηστή. Το ήθελα να εδώ. Μπορούμε να κάνουμε σχόλιο τώρα. Ωραία.
So, for the concert to begin, I will ask you first not to speak everyone at the same time, please, because of the acoustic of this room. It's very difficult to follow. And to write your complaint on one of these papers. So you have to have a pen or to share a pen with someone else. You have only one pen. And you write one complaint, very simple, very easy, about your personal life, not about the world's problems, something specific that is a complaint of yours for your life. Okay. When you're ready, you can leave your complaint here. Now I will ask you all to rise up, step up a little bit, and to form two different teams, two different categories. The pessimists from this side and the optimists from the other side. Yes, your complaint is about it.
No, my, 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 my.
Okay? So, I suggest that somebody takes a complaint from this box, and we're trying to have a debate. Like, we will try as pessimists to persuade you that this is serious, and it's not really easy to be solved, and you will try to persuade us that it is not so bad, and it can be solved.
Okay, I'm reading. Regelmäßig leben und schlafen. Was heißt das in Englisch? Live regularly? Live, ja. Yeah. So in English it means live regularly and sleep. Live regularly, sleep.
Live regularly. Live, ich weiß nicht, ob es richtig
übersetzt ist. To sleep and live regularly.
Yes. Yeah.
That this person misses sleep.
I think she misses sleep. She wants more to live more regularly and sleep more, I think.
How do you know?
It's because I'm reading it, that because everybody's a woman inside.
Okay, now we should say it's possible.
Yeah,
we'll spend less time in the internet. Yeah.
Can you smile?
But you don't know the situation of this person, so
no. Yeah.
Maybe it isn't possible.
Maybe she works very hard.
Maybe, yeah.
Yeah, she must. She must work hard.
So she has
no choice. Patient.
Can you say it again?
done, you want to do everything you can. So I don't know how to argue the for or the against that one.
Can be boring otherwise. To be always impatient, to be boring, yes.
To be patient. Because you have no sense of urgency. It's too much to be achieved. So patience is something you don't really need to have.
No, I think you have to do the right choice. When to be patient, when to be patient. And that allows you to be patient if you want to.
Is very important between patience and impatience, because I think impatience steers resistance and makes you strong. So the balance is important.
I think it's a question about when you want to be patient. When it's connected to time, it's like you're waiting for something and you can hold on, and there are a lot of other things when patience is good for you or good for the others, I don't know. But I think when it's connected to time, you can think of something to do when you're waiting for whatever, what. So, yeah.
How can patience not be connected to time?
Yes. Don't have the time, maybe it's not an appropriate time for you to be patient.
Is that what you need?
Check.
I think in patience, the focus is on time, and if you shift the focus back and distract it from time, then you gain patience.
Yeah, patience could be a good quality in, think of all the people in New York City who are impatient, but it makes shit happen. A little sense of purpose, you know, a little pace could be exciting. Maybe. A little certainty.
Yeah, but maybe it depends on also what you're waiting for. If you're waiting for asylum since 2 years, maybe it's not the case of anybody here, it doesn't look like. But then it could be time to just be disobedient instead of waiting.
Right.
I think what was written down was that you want the world to be more patient. And it's not about yourself being patient, but about too much going on, and you can't... You can't do everything you want to do and do everything that people want you to do with them together. And I think that's you don't have to. Like you can just do what you want to do and don't have to experience everything. And so I think you don't need the world to be patient. You can, as long as you have fun and you have a good time, you don't need the world to wait for you.
But I think it's also sometimes you have a lot of time and you're not patient, and I think it's not really connected to time, because you can be impatient with your artistic outcome or something and you have a lot of time, and so you're impatient with something else which is not connected to time. And yes, but I would agree also to you, because yeah, you should do what feels good, yeah, not connected to.
I actually have another issue here. Can we go to the next issue? It's sexism. Sexism. And sexism. And we're the optimists, so I have to say that sexism isn't a problem. And I personally think if everybody just behaved how they want to be treated other people the way they wanted to be treated, sexism wouldn't be an issue. And it shouldn't be. And I think it's going, or we as a society are going towards a point where it's less and less of an issue. And I hope that we'll continue to go that way worldwide.
I don't agree, because I think we're having more and more, and we have this pretense that it doesn't exist, because we have the laws say that we are all equal, but we have the young generations with the same stereotypes and roles and expectations about how boys and girls should behave, and that's still very strong in the 21st century, so I don't have the answer, but I think we need to deconstruct that and treat children and be a society which is different, because we still have women earning 30% or 20% less than men, and that's a result of sexism. We still have women being killed every day because we are supposed to be inferior. Right. So we have still a lot of manifestations of sexism which are violent.
Can I respond to that? Because it's the wage difference you just mentioned, it's a statistical thing, and it's, of course, there is a wage difference, but it's not as large as you just mentioned it.
Oh yes, it is. But it depends
on what you compare, because if you compare the jobs that are the equal jobs to each other, there's less of a wage.
Don't you find it strange that you are a man, a white man, and you're supporting these theses, and these are women and they're supporting the opposite?
It depends on
one question. Sexism, there are two aspects. The one aspect is the aspect of wages and the aspect of how women are treated in the job. That's one thing. And the other thing is, sexism in the direct contact, let's say. I think those are two aspects. And I think regarding the jobs, I would agree to him, because we are really moving in a direction where, let's say, the payment for really similar jobs is...
We are not getting the same jobs.
Yes, but look even at the university, if you look at... So I'm an engineer, and when I look at the engineering faculties, where, it's the choice of every woman and every man to study this or that, and you have, in mechanical engineering, you have about 20% women. In electronic engineering, you have about 2 or 3% of women, but it's their choice. And on the other hand, there are lots.
Point where it's not like the position that it's to be discussed anymore.
I think that's exactly the problem. Like in the last 10 years in Danish politics, just to give one example from a place that is normally known as a place that is emancipated and has very obvious rights for women, because the politics haven't paid attention to it, because they thought we all equal. It has just gone down and down and down with the wages for women, and the women in top posts in society in general. So it's something that has to be carefully done something about all the time. Yeah. Even in a welfare state, even in a Scandinavian, so to speak, emancipated country. So it's a very active thing. It's not something we can forget about at some point.
Are they ready?
Thank you. to learn everything I want to.
That's what we need.
It's too ambitious. I want to have been
people that they have spoke the most until now, that means you, you, and you two, you won't speak again.
Hard to find a flat.
Is it?
It depends always where you're from. I'm from Brazil. In Brazil, it's hard also.
It's hard.
Yes.
Why?
Why? Because there's so much red tape. And it's expensive. I live in São Paulo, everything is very expensive. Who wrote this, may I ask? Just leave it here.
Don't want to reveal himself or herself. He can speak.
All of us should.
Yeah. All of us?
All of us.
What about
and
him?
Wait. Why all of us? Should we vote about stopping like these two people that have spoken a lot from speaking?
Maybe it was their thing, so when there's another one, maybe I speak more.
Maybe they're more confident.
Anyway, I want to make my
invited you to create a collective
subject. Let me make my point first. In Melbourne, and this is a fact.
Sorry.
This is a fact. Do you want me to leave? You said no one could leave. This is a
no,
fact.
No, I mean, like,
just
where
fact.
This confidence comes from? Why you seem to have a lot of confidence?
Why not?
You seem to have a lot of confidence.
I have a lot of confidence.
Yeah.
Of course.
Why? Where it comes from?
Why do I have a lot of confidence?
Where does your confidence come from?
No, let me finish. I just want to make a point. because you said here to my friend, I have to admit that we're both big talkers, that, you know, her figures were wrong. Her stats were absolutely accurate. She knows her stats. And this is a fact too. So in Melbourne, there are all these new high-rise buildings, and there's not enough accommodation, even in a country where the population is so small. So
if we should think about things together, if this should be a space of thinking together, we should really use this force of being from different places in the world. I'm quite interested in what's not happening where I'm.
The comment was valid. The people that they speak their mother language have more confidence and they spoke more.
But no one said you couldn't speak in your mother tongue. No one said you couldn't speak.
Okay, let's make two other groups then. And maybe people that think that it's not a matter of confidence and everybody should speak as they want to should go in this place. And people that think that maybe people that feel very confident to speak in public should try not to speak so much to leave space for the other people that are not should go on this space. Am I not clear? Okay. People that vote that everybody speaks should go this way, and people that think that maybe the we must forbidden from the most confident people to speak must go on this.
Is this something we want to divide because of this?
Yeah. Oh. Divide.
I mean, what you're asking is for confident people to self-regulate, to be respectful of other people around them who might not feel so confident to speak and to give them that opportunity. I think even if some of us are speaking more, it doesn't mean we haven't given other people the opportunity. If there's been silences, people haven't said anything, and so then we fill in the space. I don't think the confident people have been disrespectful.
Yeah, I think this is a good thing if the confident people actively try to encourage the others to speak, and not just be silent as well.
Yeah.
So somebody has to say something, so I think it's better to encourage them.
Okay, let's divide into other categories, the people that have spoken and people who haven't spoken.
Does it count?
lot doesn't know what participating, so I think it's kind of weird to divide the group into the speakers and the speakers.
Yes, it's a very bad feeling. So I feel like, I have to do something very wrong. You know? Yeah, you have to describe.
Yes!
Do you have another suggestion?
So how many people in this group have English as their first language?
But they talk.
There is another.
Can I say that I'm the only person in this room who has only one language? How many people here only have one language?
Me! Oh! Two of us.
You're all so fortunate.
Out of touch.
The complaint.
Yeah, it's a complaint. Out of touch.
Either the person saying that they're out of touch or that the world's out of touch.
Now it gets impersonal again, and I would like to talk about us somehow, and to talk about our lives and who we are. That would be interesting, yeah. And where we're from.
Yeah, but the complaints are actually about us, isn't it? I mean, the complaints on the paper, it is about us, isn't it?
Yeah,
we wrote it, them.
It is. This problem with I. Even if I agree with the complainant, so I have to be the optimistic person, although I don't see it optimistic. And this is very difficult for me.
And everything you do is about you. Yeah. Everything.
Somehow we end up talking about the division more than the papers, what's in the papers. So we better talk about the papers. And what divides us.
I think also that it's actually the two of you who are guiding us, who are trying to divide us all the time. And I think this works very well in order not to discuss anything, but to make like sides instead. It's kind of a fascist method, no?
You know, what's the definition of fascism for you? What you don't like?
Telling people that they don't belong together, that there are divisions that are important so that they cannot speak together or that they are opposed.
Do you have any better suggestion to learn each other faster?
To what?
To learn about each other faster? Do you have any better suggestion?
Splitting up
no, I think they try to provoke us.
Yeah,
to,
I think so.
To come to the conclusion that this is. Dividing is not the way to do it.
Yeah.
Yes, you're dividing us, divide and conquer. But maybe we could get together in smaller groups and
talk about
our thoughts.
And be personal. Specific.
Maybe big groups are scary because they put pressure on people.
That's
pressure
a
to,
yeah. Absolutely.
To expose themselves.
But isn't that a kind of division you propose?
It is, but actually it's a division with the purpose of getting closer to each other. We could try at least.
Do you have another proposition?
Yeah.
Just remember being the kid who was never picked for the
what?
Team, the sports. You know what I mean? And I feel like...
Yeah. okay, that's the situation, but nobody wants to be picked. So. Who knows? You.
No, but smaller groups can be created like out of 1, 2, 3, 4, or division into letters in your name, or whatever. Very rational and non-personal.
Groups speaking and their groups listening.
You think that's good that we have that?
No, perhaps we just make a. In Deutsch heißt es eine Runde machen. Something like give a speech to the neighbor and just one sentence and something like this.
Should we make a circle?
Why do you want to plan anyway? I mean, we are in the middle of it. Yes. What's the purpose of a plan? I don't get that.
It's just, we're doing quite well. Yeah. It's the ethic of source debate. It's just debate.
No, but what we are experiencing here is that more and more people are joining in a certain habit. Speak. Isn't it like that?
I think one topic is division, a big topic, and we as social human beings, we don't want to be divided, so now we want to say, okay, we don't want to be discriminated because we speak a lot, or we are confident, or we are mother tongue English speakers, or whatever. I think just the wish from unification, from one big circle, is that actually everyone can participate and is kind of equal. And even like small groups might have like regional differences, and maybe that's just a wish in, to make a big group like a society, and that everyone can be heard.
Yes.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And let's solve each other's problems then.
Participation, or what, and how we can know if people are participating or not, because like it doesn't mean that I'm not part of something when I don't, when I just agree, but like really consciously agree. Maybe it doesn't. I don't need to celebrate.
For me, it's also a question: why do I have to participate through language? So, but I felt like for me, it's very interesting to be aware of the dynamic of body language, also the maybe the impatience that people want to say something and that something doesn't happen. And so, I don't know. I feel like I can participate without using words for it.
Okay, so the last division, I think, on the whole it works, because many of the people that were not speaking spoke these last 10 minutes that we did this division. And the whole topic reminds me a lot about the talk we had a few minutes earlier about sexism.
And of course, it's not the point about the specific people in this specific situation, because of course they can just accidentally stay silent for the whole time. Of course, this is a possibility. But on the whole, believing that we are all the same, equal, and we all have the same education, confidence, and fluency in the language, and all this stuff is a big trap for all of us. And this is what reminds me of sexism, because it reminds me of what this sir over there said, that it is their choice, it is the women's choice, not to go in the technical schools, for example, and stuff like that. And this is the same, like saying it's their choice not to speak, without thinking if it is their choice or not, because maybe it is, but maybe it's not. I mean, maybe some people could not, maybe there are some people here that could not speak English, for example, so well, and they were unconfident to expose their that they had this problem, but we did not even think of asking. I mean, even after the division, there was one person that hadn't spoken and was confident enough to speak, but we didn't ask the other people if it also would work for them as it would for you.
But I think that there was the tendency to make a big circle.
I agree with Anai that it was
to let everyone be heard.
It was like kind of absurd. With power negating the very fact that they have the power, and also the division, I think, helped some people to speak, but still we don't have the whole room. It's not that all of the people have spoken. For me, this the language barrier and the fact of money and education is problematic in circumstances.
Who are you talking to?
It's for our research. At the last minutes, we check out and we speak about what has happened every day.
Why don't you do it when we're gone? Because he was talking. That was not nice.
It's very funny.
So
what was your conclusion? I think
everybody
would like to know what your conclusion was.
I have seen the whole concert from the start until now, and I think it's very difficult for us to form a collective and have the same amount of privilege into speaking or into being inside the room, and it's every time problematic. And the fact that they didn't want to accept the very problem, the privileged people didn't want to accept the very problem. For me, it was very interesting.
Thank you.